please subscribe and don't forget to press the bell icon to get notified whenever we upload a new video.
Hi, good afternoon. Welcome to Halftime Report. I'm Sumaira Abdi and with me is my colleague Nigel D'Souza. Hi, Nigel. Good afternoon to you. It's Friday. The Bulls have taken a bit of a breather, so I guess I hope they're back in action on Monday, though.
That's right, Sumaira. You know, we saw a bit of a pullback, but that as well has got sold into. Now we're virtually at the low point of the day, sitting with a cutoff around 45 points. And also keep an eye out on the crisscross lines. Remember, it's a Friday. They met each other and then, in fact, you know, they went apart. And now it seems that they're getting back to each other as well. So let's pull up the advanced decline your stocks. Look at that. They're coming together on a Friday.
And, you know, interestingly, though, you know, we're down about a half odd percent now in the frontline indices, but we're doing better than what our Asian peers are doing. Yes. So, you know, the Shanghai index has lost in excess of a percent. Nikkei is down, you know, Kospi is down about 0.7%. So compared to what's happening in Asia, in the Indian market itself, not looking too bad.
That's right, Sumaira. You know, that's a valid point that you're making. And also, if you compare ourselves with another emerging market like the Brazilian index, that's lost 16% since its recent high. Now, the Nifty is only around 4.5% away from our all-time high. So just keep that in mind as well. A good performance is what you've seen in the last couple of trading sessions. Let's see whether or not the bulls can cut some of these losses in the second half of trade. First up, let's run you through all the top stories. The bulls take a bit of a breather after a good run in the last...
All right, so let's get straight to the stocks which are in focus today. It's time for movers and shakers. And first up is Tata Motors. Sonia.
Well, thanks a lot for that. You know, Tata Motors has been the beginner, not just today, but for the last couple of days. Now, what they did do is report very good Jaguar Land Rover retail sales for the month of May. The percentage growth might just look like 6%, but what this has done is two consecutive months of an up move in JLR sales. Brokerages have been quite sanguine post the numbers. City has a buy with a target price of 480. They say it's the second consecutive month of an up move as far as Jaguar Land Rover sales are concerned. And there's been a very strong showing in the UK market, although we did see you know, the Chinese and the European markets falter. Credit Suisse has an outperform with a target price of 460. Elara Capital is one of the few brokerages in town who actually upgraded the stock post the weak Q4 numbers. But they say that the JLR growth now for second month running, ex of China, has hit the highest in the last 14 months. So it's definitely, you know, turning around. Remember, the Chinese market was down 8% this time, but there was a reason for that. Customers were actually postponing their purchases because of an impending price cut post the import duty. Cut from the 1st of July. So because of that, a lot of people believe that in the month of July, the China numbers will pick up a lot. So all in all, good set of numbers. Second month running, the JLR has done well and brokerages are quite optimistic. The next important date to watch for Tata Motors is 24th of June, when they will be having an analyst day in UK at the Jaguar Land Rover office. So, you know, this is the first time that N. Chandra, the chairman of the Tata Group, will be attending that conference. So it would be interesting to see the takeaways there.
Okay. All right, Sonia, thanks so much for that. Well, let's focus on Usha Martin. In the last couple of days, the stock has been running along. In fact, it's up nearly around 30% odd in two sessions. Prince Matthews Thomas of moneycontrol.com, he joins in to tell us that Tata Steel, they're joining the race for Usha Martin's Jamshedpur unit. Prince, fill us in.
Yes. Now, Tata Steel has put in an aggressive bid of 6,000 crore for Usha Martin's Jamshedpur facility. And this, we believe, is higher than what JSW has offered.
Okay.
Mr. Martin has been looking to sell the some of his assets to pare down his debt, which right now stands at about 3,700 crore. Now, the interesting part is that Tata Steel has bid aggressively for two reasons. One, Usha Martin's facility is very close to Tata Steel's own plant in Jamshedpur. So the synergies would be immediate.
Yes.
And second, to Tata Steel's backyard. And it wouldn't want a competitor like JSW Steel making a presence there. But it's still too early to call the race. I think the process is still on. And I think equations could still change. So we have to keep looking at what's happening.
Okay. All right. Thanks so much, Prince. Well, just to tell our viewers, watch out for a couple of points. Prince told us that, in fact, he's ranging the debt at around 3,500 crores odd. So we'll have to keep an eye out on that front. Remember, in the last year, the finance cost itself was around 590 crores. You know, so we'll have to get the absolute debt that would go with this books. And also, we'll have to keep in mind, are they selling both the units? That's the steel unit as well as the wire rods business unit. Are both of them going, or is just one of them going? And I also want to know, what is the backward integration there? Remember, they had iron ore as well as captive coal at, you know, at some point of time. Now, we'll have to see whether or not all those factors are intact. Interesting story. Usha Martin, the stock you should be looking at. We have heard this in the past, but now, in fact, Prince is giving us a fresh update. But let's hop across to Anisha. She's got a lot more stocks that are in the news today. Anisha.
Hi, Nigel. Thank you so much for that. Good afternoon. Well, first up, I'd like to start with Omex Auto because that stock was trending higher. And the reason is because the board has approved diversification as well as expanding the capacity. Now, that will cost them around 100 to 120 crores, but the street is excited by more revenue opportunities. Moving on to quality, wherein the stock has lost around 70% YTD. Today as well, it was down about 5% after the company got added to the additional surveillance measure list. Yesterday, remember, the management joined us, but they could not answer a lot of questions regarding buyback, etc. So something that the street is watching out for. A sector that you cannot take your eyes away from today is the pharma space. So a lot of these stocks are buzzing. Sun Pharma, for example, is up around 5%. Ajanta Pharma, Stride Shasun, Dr. Reddy's, Wockhardt, Apollo Hospital, Cadila. All these pharma names are up anywhere between 3 to 7, 8%. A few more stocks that are buzzing. Well, CG Power on the upside is higher. Syntex Industries has also seen a smart up move of around 8%. On the flip side, however, Jet Airways is down about 3%. And Power Grid is another stock that has been seeing quite a bit of pressure this week. Today, it's down about 3%. The other bit of stocks that will be in focus today is the public sector bank. Because remember, they are meeting the finance minister today. So the likes of PNB, Allahabad Bank, Andhra Bank are all in focus. Lastly, on Adani Transmission, well, the promoters have there created a pledge of around 8.82 crore shares. So that one is seeing a bit of red tick. Back to you.
All right, Anisha, thanks very much for that. Mahindra Industries, that's been a big wealth creator, and they've posted very strong earnings as well in Q4. The bottom line rising 2.5 times compared to the same period last year. We caught up with Sudhir Jain, the group CFO, to talk about the outlook for FY19. Let's hear him out.
We hope to maintain similar kind of growth in years to come, particularly 18, 19 and 19, 20. Our internal target being that EBITDA, we want to take it to 12.5%, which is within reach. And as the capacity utilization is increasing, productivity is improving. So we hope that in times to come, we should cross 12.5% EBITDA margin on an annualized basis.
Well, here's a quick recap of all the buzzing stocks we just covered. We have Tata Motors, Tata Steel, Omax Auto. You have Quality, some pharma stocks like Sun Pharma, Janda, Strides, Dr. Reddy's, Wockhardt, as well as Apollo Hospitals and Cadila Health, CG Power, Syntex Industries, Jet Airways, Power Grid, PNB, the whole host of stocks, I think, Andhra Bank, as well as Adani Transmission.
All right, and well, Fortis doesn't stay out of the news for too long. So once again, it's back on our radar, rather on Ekta's radar. Ekta, what's going on now? It's the last lap.
Well, yes, the due diligence is currently on. Remember that there is a 10-day due diligence. We understand from sources that majority of the players have already finished due diligence, and it's probably just the last leg with one player left in terms of the management meets, etc. Now, in terms of what we want to highlight with regards to Fortis is that Monday would be a very important day on the 11th of June. This would be post the due diligence that the Q4 numbers would be announced for the company, and separately the Luthra and Luthra report, which would be the internal audit of what exactly has happened in the company, will also be announced. Now, for the Luthra and Luthra report, reports have indicated that they have brought up issues with regards to land of three of the hospitals concerned with Fortis, as well as there have been some amount of vendor dues of over 400 odd crores, which could be in question, as well as a penalty which is due with regards to Fortis Escorts. So it'll be interesting to see what exactly the Luthra and Luthra report brings up, and whether or not that would change the kind of bids we could see from the four bidders at this point in time. And that final bid would come in on the 14th of June.
Hi, welcome back. You're watching Halftime Report. Well, it's status quo as of now for the market, under pressure, down about 0.5%, but not moved lower still. But let's get in some big voices. Legendary investor Warren Buffett and the chairman and CEO of JP Morgan, Jamie Dimon, have come together and made a plea to corporate America. The two titans believe that companies should stop announcing quarterly profit forecasts. They argue that if companies think only in terms of 3 months, it could hurt their long-term planning. In fact, Buffett went on to argue that companies do certain things that are counterproductive in the longer term just to achieve their quarterly forecasts.
All right, then keep an eye out on the Nifty. We've virtually moved to the low point of the day. So you should get that up for you on the screen. And not just that, you pull up HDFC. That's the big boy in there. I think that slipped in the last few minutes. And that explains why, in fact, the Nifty did move lower. That's HDFC Bank. I think we should get HDFC as well up for you on the screen. And the banking stocks as well. The Nifty Bank should come up for you. Yes, HDFC has moved lower. HDFC Bank has moved lower. And the Nifty Bank has now moved. It's down close to around 220 points odd as we speak. It's recovered a tad bit. But keep an eye out on the broader markets. That has been the troublesome part of the market just a couple of sessions ago. Today, we started off with more number of stocks that were declining. Then they crossed each other. We had more number of stocks just a short while back that were advancing than declining. And now they've crossed each other. So that is something that you should really, really keep your eye out on. The headline index is in the green, but otherwise, more number of stocks are trading in the red, as that chart tells you. Well, we'll slip into a short break and we'll tell you how do you trade the Nifty on the other side of the short break. Ashwini Gujral and Prakash Kaba, they'll be with us. Well, drifting towards the 10,715-odd mark, that's from where we've seen a bit of a bounce. That's the low point of trade, 10,710-odd. But moving on then, Interim Finance Minister Piyush Goyal is in Mumbai today and we'll be meeting the heads of several PSU banking stocks, in fact. Ritu Singh joins us for a heads up. Ritu, what can be expected from today's meeting?
Piyush Goyal, who has the interim charge of the finance ministry until Arun Jaitley is back in office, will be meeting with the heads of public sector banks today in Mumbai. We do understand that the meeting is being hosted at the State Bank of India headquarters in Nariman Point, and several bank heads, including those from Mumbai-based banks and several other heads from banks that are headquartered in southern India, are expected to be at the meeting. It is a day-long meeting where the FM will be taking stock of the bank's progress, after they've reported their fourth quarter earnings. We understand that on the agenda is the discussion on the roadmap for banks, 11 banks that are under prompt corrective action from RBI, to ensure that there's no credit flow constraint in those banks. Also on the agenda will be risk governance, something that has been the focus for the banking industry for quite some time since the emergence of the frauds in these public sector banks. So those are the key items on the agenda. There is a possibility of mergers also being discussed, but of course all of that will be known later in the day when Piyush Goyal will be holding a press conference at the State Bank of India headquarters at 4 p.m.
All right, so as of now, the PSU banks look to be heading higher. But let's invite our technical experts then. Ashwini Gujral and Prakash Gaba join in. Gentlemen, good afternoon to both of you. So bulls look to be taking a bit of a breather today. Ashwini, first up, your call on the index.
See, it's clear that this post-rate hike rally is now becoming over. And the problem today is that, large private sector banks, which are owned by institutions and the largest of players, they are coming under the hammer. And not only private banks, even large stocks like ITC, Larsen, banks like HDFC Bank, ICICI Bank. So definitely somebody has used this pullback rally to sell into the market. And this pharma rally, etc., this is not sustainable. So my sense is right now still a good time to get short. I think if not today, on Monday, we should get closer to 10,550-600. Keep a high of the day today as your stop. And my sense is that we should be lower in the days to come. Having said that, HDFC is a sell with a stop of 1840, target of 1810. ICICI Bank is a sell with a stop of 291, target of 278. And Tata Global is a buy with a stop of 264, target of 278.
All right, then, cautious view coming in on the Nifty. Prakash, what about you? Your trade for today?
Nifty to me certainly is looking weak. We can see lower levels in the day, possibly. I have two stocks, one long, one short. Apollo Hospital looks good to me. Can see a climb to around 1020 zones. Stop below 980 on Apollo Hospital should be fine. Canara Bank looks weak. There's a very good chance it can see a slide to around 295 zones. Canara Bank can climb up to around 295 zones, stop below 272. Canara Bank is a buy, not a sell.
Okay, all right. Thanks so much for that, Prakash. Ashwini, I just want to ask you about a couple of these stocks that have bounced back quite considerably. Sun Pharma, Tata Motors, both of them have been rank underperformers. But this week itself, they're up between 7 to around 9%. How are they looking on the charts?
See, they are going to face selling again.
Okay.
This rally has been all about short covering. So why Sun Pharma, even a short covering? So why Sun Pharma, even Ajanta Pharma has gone up? CG Power has gone up. So the idea is you go with the largest stocks, which decide the trend of the market.
Okay.
I don't think these stocks decide that trend. Maybe another day of a rally, and then they are likely to fall in step with the market. So I'm more interested in seeing where are the largest stocks going, particularly in the financial space.
All right, on that note, let's take a very quick break, come back in a bit, and lots more lined up next.